With gold trim, hailing from Paris, France. He weighed in the same as his opponent, 117.5 pounds. He is undefeated in his campaign in the ring with a record of 17 wins, no losses, 12 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, in the third defense of his title, here is the current, reigning and defending, undefeated WBC Bantamweight Champion of the World, introducing Nordin Umali. And once again, a referee in charge, Jack Reese, now to give instructions.
Take this off, please. Take it off. Right here underneath the right ear facing me. Okay, right here. Mouthpiece. All right, I got a lefty and a righty, so just watch your heads and your feet. Please listen, follow my instructions at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Fight hard, fight clean. Good luck to both of you.
In the twilight of his Hall of Fame career, can Donaire dance with destiny one more time? Or will Umali get an assist from Father Time? It's time to find out. The bell in round number one, the defending champion, Nordin Umali, the southpaw black with gold trim, the challenger, Nonito Donaire, he's blue with orange trim.
We know he's a very clever boxer, but he has knocked out six of his last eight opponents, so he's a guy that brings some power and pop in there as well.
Yeah, and expect Umali to be active in the early rounds. He's a difficult fighter, especially on the left-hand side.
Think about it, to have a bantamweight champion at the age of 58 would previously have been almost incomprehensible. And here, Nonito Donaire has a chance to make his.
Yeah, we should point out that if he were to win tonight, he would join the list of current champions among the oldest in the sport. So we'll see if he can achieve that and make that list time.
Right hand to the body by Donaire, Umali avoiding the left hook and delivering a left to the body of his own.
He gets some rounds up, you know. You want to figure out your opponent that you have in front of you. And I think Donaire is really smart at doing that. He wants to figure out the timing of this fighter.
You mentioned it at the top of the telecast as Donaire gets backed up by the left hand of Umali, but then does a good job of avoiding the other left hand, leads with a right hand. But after, you know, at his age and after what transpired in Japan 18 months ago, you wonder. If he left whatever he has left at the storied Saitama Super Arena, but countering here with a nice effective combination. But that was again 18 months ago, and both of these fighters were last in the ring in Japan.
He did talk about that. He did mention that he let his body heal. He feels good. He felt great in the gym. He feels powerful in this weight class. And again, you know, I can't say it enough. I think he should. He just did what he's doing right now. Take his time. Figure out the opponent that he has in front of him.
Donaire was very adamant when we chatted with him about the fact that he feels like he understands, you know, what three of the last seven fighters have been lefties. He said, but this camp, I feel like I'm really honed in on it.
So nice check left hook to the body by the veteran Donaire, four division champion. He's 11-1 at 118 pounds. His lone defeat coming in his last fight. That instant classic against the monster Naoya Inoue as we come to the end of round one of this bantamweight championship fight. Donaire. And again, that foot battle is going to be paramount.
And how about this? Donaire averages 49 punches per round against righties and 39 against lefties. How many do you think he...
Are we on the cusp of history at the Punch Bowl?
his illustrious career. What a round! Owen Bupali comes back and staggers Donaire, but what a round!
Father Time, take a back seat. No